I'm going to call from Washington. I am in a situation where the American is under possible hijack.
A plane just landed.
What?
It's the 737.
It what?
Like the World Trade.
Who are you talking to? Oh, God. Oh, my God.
United 175, New York. We have some problems over here right now. We might have a hijack over here, two of them.
Pentagon just got hit. God damn it, I can't even protect my NCA.
United 93, that traffic for you is 1 o'clock, 12 miles eastbound, 370.
Negative contact, we're looking, United
93. United 93, Cleveland, if you hear the center right then.
I got that piece to dock. Keep remaining sitting. We have a ball aboard.
We are going to join another one of our New York affiliates, WABC, for their live coverage.
Plane overhead, and then all of a sudden I thought it sounded kind of louder, that I looked up, and all of a sudden it smashed right dead into the center of the World Trade Center. Big flash of flame, fire coming out from all over. Then all the bricks is a huge hole right now. It almost looked like the plane probably went through. I'm not sure.
Winston, can you see? Are you on the north side there where the plane made contact?
Yes, I am.
Now, when you say a huge hole, one of our earlier witnesses, Libby Clark, said not much of the plane came down off the building. Much of it went
into the building.
It's in the building, that, from what you can see.
Right.
Now, can you see if there's a lot of debris downstairs, Winston?
No, because it looked like it inverted. With the impact, everything went inside the building.
Inside.
The only thing that came out was a little bit of the outside awning. But I'd say the hole is, let me just get a better look right now.
Okay, go ahead.
I'd say the hole takes about, looks like 6-7 floors were taken out. And there's more explosions right now. Hold on, people are running.
Hold on just a moment. We've got an explosion inside.
The building's exploding right now. You got people running up the street.
Okay.
Hold on, I'll tell you what's going on.
Okay, just put Winston on pause there for just a moment.
Okay, the whole building just exploded some more. The whole top part.
Okay.
The building's still intact. People are running up the streets. Am I still connected?
Winston, this would support probably what Libby and you both said, that perhaps the fuselage was in the building that would cause a second explosion such as that.
Well, that's what just happened then.
That certainly...
Yeah, people are running
up. We are getting word that perhaps...
Okay, hold on. The people here, everybody's panicking.
All right, Winston, let me put Winston on hold for just a moment.
Okay, I don't know how much longer I'll be staying. I'm inside of a diner right now.
Well, Winston, you know what? If you could give us a call back, I just don't want to panic here on the air. Let's just take some of our pictures from News Chopper 7. Now, one of our producers said perhaps a second plane was involved, and let's not even speculate to that point, but at least put it out there that perhaps that may have happened. The second explosion would certainly back the theory from a couple of eyewitnesses that the plane fuselage perhaps stayed in those upper buildings. Now, if you look at the second building, there are two, that both twin towers now are on fire. Now, this was not the case, am I correct? A couple of moments ago. This is the second twin tower now on fire. And we're going to check on the second flight if perhaps that had happened. This all began at about 8:48 this morning. Again, what we know, in case you're just joining us, a small plane, not a Cessna type or 5 or 6 seater, but instead perhaps a passenger flight, ran into the north side of the World Trade Center. As you can see, the second explosion that you're looking at now in the second twin tower, it has spread much debris, much more debris than the first explosion or the first accident.
All good here, Soap. Head outside and report to Sergeant Newcastle.
Water! Please!
Get down and shut the fuck up!
Water!
Look, Machine, I'm going to make this really nice and easy for you. I need names, and you're going to give them to me.
You have to listen to me. You have to listen to me. This is all a huge mistake.
Bull! Department of Homeland Security's been monitoring your calls for weeks, Rajid. We got you. We know about you and your friends. We know that you're a terrorist.
I am a terrorist. Me and my friends, we breed dogs, specifically terriers. We write terrorist fiction. We spend a good deal of time discussing possible future terrorist plots.
It's a nice try, really is. But it's bull, Rajid.
I looked up the definition of hooch, and it just happens to be a lightly thatched hut.
Oh.
Thank you, Mr. Webster.
Oh, yeah? Because you know what I got? Hooch, a highly inferior whiskey. See rock gut, see that toilet moonshine Sonny makes on
the thing. Thing highly inferior is your palate.
Echo 1. Breach in place. Preparing to assault.
Copy Echo 1. You're clear for entry.
I got you, Taylor. You're gonna be all right.
I can't feel my legs. Oh God, I can't feel my legs.
Thank you.
1-6, perimeter is secure. Have a good one. 0-6, breaking right on heading 270.
Hey, Gunfighter 1-1, we love you. Where you going?
Here we go.
Don't go!
Happens every time. Those boys were 10 seconds from meeting their maker and still...
1-1, you just don't understand the brain of a warrior.
Brain?
Check, move.
extractor going in. Stand by at the extraction point. Be ready to get us the fuck out of Dodge and things go south.
Roger, Mako.
Generator, Jordan.
Copy, Nas.
IR flashlights. Check.